I think the historical precedent of this is there's a director of the census that works for the Secretary of Commerce, the President, and also works closely with the White House to ensure a timely and accurate count, and that's what we have in this instance.
It's the Friday lightning round. We're going to start with a topic, one topic, about the census, the 2010 census being taken out of the Commerce Department, essentially, and put into oversight at the White House. We'll start with this topic. Bill Salmon.
Well, think about this. The Commerce Department has always had the Census Bureau for many years because you're supposed to insulate the Census Bureau from politics. The census, you know, every 10 years we take a census and the results have great significance. You redraw the congressional district so it impacts political power, and you distribute federal dollars based on population. So it's a political football. What do? They take it away from Judd Gregg, the newly minted nominee for Commerce, and put it in presumably Rahm Emanuel's portfolio.
White
this
House
is very alarming.
Staff.
Yes.
Juan.
Politics. The census has always been about politics. And what we've had here are Latino officials who were concerned that Judd Gregg was going to be in charge. And they said that when Judd Gregg was in the Senate, he was not supportive of making sure that there were enough officials to get the census. This is going to redraw districts. It has political consequences. So I don't see any problem with bringing it to the White House. It just makes official what we've all known. It's political.
You're going to make it unpolitical by sticking it in the White House? That sounds illogical, but to me, the Constitution has a lot of shall nots about Congress and the executive. One of the rare items it demands is a census, and it expects it would be objective, and it ought to be in Commerce.
All right, next topic. Michael Phelps, gold medal swimmer. He obviously was seen in the picture that has been seen around the world of him smoking out of a bong. Kellogg has now dropped the sponsorship of Michael Phelps, and he's been given a 3-month suspension by USA Swimming. That he says is a fair suspension. Charles.
I think we established the principle 16 years ago that as long as you don't inhale, you can end up in the White House. I suspect he did. Look, he's a nice kid. He's rather goofy. I'd give him a pass. The reason he got hit on this is because he had a DWI 4 years ago, and it's beginning to present a pattern, and that's why I think he's getting a warning here. I think slightly over-punished, I would say.
I agree with Charles. I think there's a lot of tutting going on here. And to my mind, this is silliness. Look, he's a kid, and he's, you know, let him have his way, let him have his mistakes, and move on. Why he needs to be punished? He's a role model? Yes, he's a role model. He's a great swimmer. If it goes to excess, okay, but I don't see any excess.
It's
so far.
The bong hit heard around the world. I mean, you can't feel too sorry for him. He's still going to be making millions of dollars. He'll still go on to swim and get gold medals in Olympics. But I think when you're marketing to kids through Kellogg's, Frosted Flakes, or whatever, you've got to be careful you're not sending the wrong message. I think it's an appropriate punishment. He'll still be a rich man, believe me.
All right, surprise of the week. Charles, your surprise of the week.
Well, we all watched the big game, and we heard Jennifer Hudson do a spectacular national anthem, and then we learned that it was lip syncs, and I'm shocked and deeply disappointed. Also, oh yeah, Faith Hill, America the Beautiful,
also lip synced.
Absolutely, and I think I think it establishes a precedent. I think I should announce on behalf of all of us, it's starting on Monday. The panel will be lip sync.
All right, Juan, your surprise of the week.
Well, you know, there's all this concern, more tutting about Barack Obama going into the Oval Office in short sleeves. And then I came to learn that, 2 days after he took office, there was President Bush in the Oval Office without his jacket on. And he's always spoken of reverence for the Oval Office. But I think that people were quick to jump on Obama, and it was an example of a double standard.
All right.
I was surprised that President Obama would drop charges against the alleged mastermind of the USS Cole bombing and then meet with the Cole victims' families the next day instead of the other way around.
That's it for the Friday Lightning Round, but stay tuned to see a prime example of accentuating the negative.